So, we kick off with Jan Singh with the most burning topic of the day, India and China. Okay. Sir, first thing, honestly speaking, where do we stand now?
See, it is important to look back. And there are two things which would be very apparent to you. We became independent in 47. China came up in 49 after the Great March was over. Kuomintang was defeated. The PRC came into existence. Not much of a difference. But thereafter, there has been a difference in approach. And since national security concerns every possible thing that impacts security, we need to look at these. In India, the leadership that came up, imbued with the thoughts of non-violence, imbued with peace and harmony for everybody, imbued with looking at raising the standard of living of people. In China, things were slightly different. They had greater poverty than us. Much greater poverty. In fact, if somebody wants to get an idea of the type of poverty China had, I would recommend a book called Mao's Last Dancer. Read what type of poverty existed there. But they were more concerned on how the nation's borders are. Can they look back into the history and restore what many, many hundred years back they had or they had notions of having? And therefore you find that 49 onwards, China's whole approach has been more militaristic as compared to India.
But were you not prepared at that point of time?
See, it is not that we were not prepared, but the leadership at that time, and I don't want to take names, but our Prime Minister at that time, his thinking was that we are a peaceful country, we have got no enemies, why should anybody be enemy with us? And therefore our borders are secure, we don't require military. Military is good for constructing houses, making roads. We don't actually require to guard our borders. Chinese on the other side said, no, this so-called Turkic Xinjiang, we need to have it because it helps us in securing our borders. We must have Tibet, although they had claims over outer Tibet, but they harbored the desire to have inner Tibet. They must consolidate themselves in Yunnan, and they must consolidate themselves, which they got an opportunity in 50s when the Korean War broke out. So you find that China, the way they came up with a long-term view of how they should be, they laid emphasis on the borders, while we laid emphasis on development inside. And therefore, when Aksai Chin gets taken or the road comes up, we are caught by surprise.
They're talking about the Daulat Bag or Lee Road.
We were caught by surprise because we never thought that we should ever go and see that area.
Right.
And the famous remark of Pandit Nehru, not a blade of grass grows there. Okay, not a blade of grass grows there, but that land belonged to you. Today, you are saying that land belonged to us. And same was Tibet. The policies that followed on Tibet resulted in China becoming stronger. And China getting a view of India that if you do a thing with India, they will get into legalistic, long-term negotiations, which is to the advantage of China.
সমস্ত খবরের তৎক্ষণাৎ আপডেট পেতে সাবস্ক্রাইব বাটনটি ক্লিক করে বেল বাটনটি ক্লিক করুন।
আরো খবরের আপডেট পেতে সাবস্ক্রাইব করুন আমাদের ইউটিউব চ্যানেলটি আর বেল আইকনে ক্লিক করুন নোটিফিকেশনস পেতে।